Hello everyone and welcome to another tutorial of Mastering Arduino from Beginner to Core Advanced. In this tutorial, we are going to discuss about a very important function, that is serial write. Well, I have named it serial write in place of serial print because I will be telling you because there is an important part. Because you can say that serial write is a description for serial print. There are basically four type of values that we can print. It can be an integer, it can be a float, it can be a character, or it can be string. So I have used the word serial write so that we can say that we are printing multiple values on it. Well, there is nothing such as serial write in Arduino, but for the sake of convenience, I am saying it's serial write. And let's just begin the Arduino. First of all, we need to call in sketch. We have called it. First of all, we are going to discuss about the integer and how to print it on the screen. I have connected an Arduino. First of all, I need to discuss about integer. So I am setting an integer, say integer x, and giving a value, say 77. That's it. Now come here. For always working in serial, it is necessary to call the serial monitor or serial port BEGIN. Say you can say 9600, but you can define as your own wish, such as 115200, but the value should be same. There are only a few values that can be used in it. Okay, come down here, call serial dot print and say the value integer x. And now let me explain you. I have called an integer x giving a value 77, called serial monitor with baud rate 9600 and giving a value of print fx, but I have done a mistake. I am going to tell you afterward. Okay, first of all, I am going to upload it to the board. It's taking some time and you can see here it's uploading. It's compiling first, taking its value to the hexadecimal and uploading to the board. Okay, the upload is done. Now what you can see, that is a string of 7777 continuously going on, because the line cannot terminate itself, because you need to define it to terminate. For that, come here and write print ln. Now see what happens. There are also functions such as \n for new line, but we are using print ln. Okay, open here and see, you can see only one value in a line. This is the method. Okay, come here, we are going to do an experiment. I don't know does it happens in Arduino or not, because it happens in C, \n. Okay, let's just try it. And it's calling the value and it's saying it's a mistake. Okay, let me give two inverted columns, commas in it. Okay, now let's just try it. Again, it's saying char to integer not permissible. Okay, I'm going here. There is a simple method. If the values does not work in the same line, remember one thing, there is a very simple method. You can call it in another line. This is the most suitable method. Say \n. Now terminate the line and upload it to the board. What happens? Let's just see. And you can see that it works. This is the method. You can use the word ln, print ln, or you can use the \n, but I prefer to use the word ln because it takes only one line, or in other case you need to give the value to the same line, multiple functioning will be calling, or simply you can use the word ln. So I prefer ln. Okay, let's just try it with another thing. Well, you have seen the value of x in the form of decimal, but if you want to see its value in binary, can we do it? Well, yes. Write BIN in capital with a comma and just upload it to the board. Let's just see what happens. It's taking some time, no problem. And see here, the value of 777 is coming in the form of binary. My mistake, I have not called the next line value ln. I am going to upload it. The value of x is 77, but now it will be coming in the form of binary. 1010, the computer language. The computer is reading it in the form of 101101. But if you want to call it in hexadecimal, is it possible? Well, I will say it is possible. Just write the value hex in capital with a comma with the value, and the parameter is called hexadecimal. So let's just see what happens. I can see that the value is coming in 4D. The value for 77 is in decimal, but its value in hexadecimal is 4D. Well, for D, I will have to say you that for up to 9, it's okay. For 10, the value A is used. For 11, value B. And up to 16, the value E is used. E or F is used. I don't know the absolute value of it. Okay, come to the next part. Okay, this was about hexadecimal. Let's try it with octadecimal. Octadecimal, it means that the value is up to only 8. ओके जस्ट अपलोड इट टू द बोर्ड, इट्स अपलोडिंग. 0 to 7 विल बी द वैल्यू फॉर ऑक्टा डेसिमल एंड इट विल कमिंग आउट 0 to 7 इट विल बी 8 वैल्यूज और यू कैन से 2 raised to 3 इट्स वैल्यू इज 115. ओके दैट वॉज इनफ फॉर इंटीजर बट वॉट वी वॉट हैपन आई एम डूइंग एक्सपेरिमेंट आई एम कॉलिंग इट 77.55 और 66 लेट जस्ट से इट्स सेइंग 77.66 व्हाट हैपन लेट जस्ट चेक इट्स ऑल्सो एन इंटरेस्टिंग थिंग जस्ट सी हियर इट विल से 78 और 77 इट्स सेइंग 77 बिकॉज इट कैनॉट रीड द फ्लोट वैल्यू फॉर अ फ्लोट वैल्यू यू हैव टू कॉल समथिंग कॉल्ड FLOAT इट विल टर्न इन टू ब्लू से फ्लोट y इज इक्वल टू से 3.14 नाउ कॉल द वैल्यू y हियर इट्स अपलोडिंग टेकिंग सम टाइम नो प्रॉब्लम and it has been successfully uploaded. Okay, open here. You can see the value 3.14. Okay, let's just do another interesting experiment. Its absolute value is 3.1415. That is the value of pi 79. I want to show you something interesting. What would happen if you called 6 places to the decimal? Does it read? Well, it will not. You can say only 3.14 is showing. There are about 6 values to the decimal, so you have to do something interesting. Go down. Give a comma and give the value 6. Now what happens? See here. You can call up to 6 places to the decimal by using this method. And you can see all the 6 values are coming. But what happens if I want to call only 4? Okay, it will round figure itself to the 4th value and see what happens here. And it's calling itself. And you can see only 4 values and last value is 15. But it has round figure it from 579 to 6. Okay, now this was all about integers and float, but what about if you want to write a character such as ABC or anything? So we are calling char character, say character c. C is the value that is storing the character. Remember one thing, it is not the character that will be printing, but it is the value. For that is an interesting part. Use 2 commas and write a value such as say a. So the value of character c will be a. Come here, write C. We are calling C, but it is calling the value A because it is stored inside the character value. It's saying a mistake. I have not terminated the line, so I terminate it. Now again, I'm going to upload it. It's uploading. Just wait for a second. And let's just see what happens. You can see that we have called C, but it's printing value A. But what happened? You can say we printed A, B, C. I want to show you something interesting. First of all, it will not take the value itself. It's taking the value, then no problem. Let's just see. In calling ABC, we have called the value of character, so it will print the value C. For the sake of convenience, I am saying ABD, so you will not get confused. I am calling ABD. The value that only going to print is the last value of the character string, and that is D. Okay, come here and see. We can only see the D because anything that is stored more than a value will not be read. For if you want to read multiple lines, that is a simple method. You have to use the value string. S-T-R-I-N-G, S should be capital, I-N-G, string, say, string S is equal to, say, hello world. We are using also a space here, W-O-R-L-D, hello world, terminate the line. Use 2 inverted commas for each time because if 1 inverted comma cannot use the value of string. Upload it to the board, it's uploading and it's saying a mistake. We have done a mistake initializing constant. Okay, I have not given the value of equal to, I have given it, and bottom we have done a mistake, we are not calling the value s, so s is done here. Okay, I am going to upload it, and it's uploading, and you can see the value hello world on the screen, and you can see that the hello world can be printed on the screen. And one thing interesting, if you want to print the value say 65, it does not require a termination column for the character. You can simply write 65 and terminate the line. It does not require inverted columns, say C, and now see what happens. It's quite a bit interesting. It's saying the value A because the SC value of C, A is 65. The SC value, A American standard value of 65 is A. If I say the value to 66, it will print value B. Let's just do it. I am going to print the value 66 and it's uploading to the board. Just wait for a second and it's uploaded successfully. Say what happens. it will be printing the value capital B. You can see here, if you want to do it, give it a comma starting and end and see what happens. It will print value or not. Let's just check it. And you can see here the value is 6 because it is only reading the last value. It has taken it as a character, but only last character can be read. See, 67, going to upload it with character value and see what happens. Only 7 will be read here. Well, there are many other functions which are related to print, but only these 4 are necessary for you. We can recall the section, such as for integers, 77, you can use int. For float, such as 3.1415, we are using the comma and using the value. For 6 places to decimal, use 6. For octadecimal, use OCT capital. For hexadecimal, use XEX. For decimal, or you can say binary, use capital BIN. For reading only one character, you can use CHAR. And for reading a whole string, we are using string with two inverted commas. You can see here there are two inverted commas here and hold the string. Okay, you can get the code and you can do your own practice if you want. And if you have any question, please ask me, or else thanks for watching.